Okay, in this chapter, we are doing infinity and indirect statement. So, in this chapter, infinitive and indirect statements. Same like English, we do direct and indirect. So first we do infinity. In Latin, there are four type of verb and each verb has four principal parts. For example, the first verb is this type of amo, amare, and amavi, amaru. And second verb is this type of monio, monere, monui, monitu. And third verb has in it two type of, one is ago and its infinitive is agere, and this is perfect and perfect passive is actum. And the second part is this type of verb capio, capere, capi, captum, and fourth is audio, odire, odivi, auditum. So we call infinitive. These are present in the previous chapter we have done, and this is perfect. So this is present active, present active, and this is infinitive, and this is perfect, and this is perfect passive. So these are infinitive. Now this infinitive mean, like this mean to love. So here we don't know the subject. This mean I love, that means subject is there. And here I have loved, here also subject. So this how we use normally, like if I write a sentence, amare nom pojum. So this mean to love, this mean not, and this mean I am able. I am able. So the meaning become I am not able to love. Or this mean this become I am not able to love. Right? If I use in place of amir, amari, if I change this e to I, then it become passive of amir. That means if I say amari non pujo. So this means I can't or I am not able, I am not able, and this means this become passive of amari. This is active, this is passive, so this become to be loved. So the meaning of the sentence become I am not able to be loved, to be loved. So it become I am not able to be loved. So this is the passive. That means their passive is here. This is their passive, we can write. Passive means to be. Its passive I am writing here. Amari. That means E is replaced with I. And this is monad. But here is a change. This is agi. This is agi. So this part is, and this is cat, and this is odair. So these parts are the passive of the infinitive. Now these are present passive. So these are present passive. Now we look for present already known, perfect and future passive. So you have to remember these changes of the infinitive to convert a present infinitive to passive infinitive. Now, I take all three sentences. This is present and this is perfect and this is future. So this is I write active and this I write here passive. So I am taking only one verb, third. So active is agere and passive become agi. Now what is the perfect part? Perfect part is the third part of the verb, that agi. This is perfect part of your verb. So with this we add double SE, that is agise. Agise. So this means we say to lead or to do, and this means to be led, and this means because it is perfect, so have will be there, to have led. And this part is passive because the fourth part is passive, so this become It is here. Actus, actus for male, and if I add a, then it become, that mean acta. This become acta, and comma actum. This is for male, this is for female, and this is for neuter, and with this we add s. So this mean to have been led. So this mean to have been led. Now we come to the future. Future is from the fourth part, acturus. This is something new. Acturus. So, urus is the sign of future. Acturus, and this is for male and for female. Actura. And for neuter, acturum plus esse. This means future, that means it is about to happen or about going to happen. So this is for female and this is for neuter, that means to be going to lead. Now this become the passive of future, become acturum iri. So it is acturum iri. So this esse is changed with iri, and this means to be going to be led. To be going to be led. So here is to be, here going to be led. So these things we have to remember. Imperfect, this third verb, third part of the verb become esse, and the fourth we add esse because the fourth part is itself active, and then the meaning change to have been led, and future is acturus, actura for female, and for neuter acturum esse, and acturum iri is passive. So this part we have to be noted. So this is looking somewhat ugly. So this is the technique we have to learn, and now I make the whole model, or we use direct in the sentence, then it will be clear. Now, what is the use of this infinitive? The use of infinitive, what is the use? When we change it is, or simply is used to change direct statement, into indirect statement. We learn this, how it is used. So we take example how infinitive is used. Like, if I say Julia Magister Inquirit, or it is simply I say now, this is in the inverted commas, ist discipula bona, ist discipula bona. Or this means Julia. He says, he said, is, bona discipula mean, good student. So this is direct statement. Now, if I change in indirect statement, then how we can make it? This become Diki, because it is inquit is the past. So I change inquit Julian. Now it is accusative, and this ist, this will be, because what is the infinitive? Sum esse, this is infinitive. So this esse, because ist is the present case, so we use present, this become Julian esse bonam discipula, bonam esse Diski Pulam Bona. So what is the change? In direct statement, ist discipula, this statement I think better if I write like this, inquit comma, inverted comma, Julia ist discipula bona. So this is direct statement. Now this become inquit. He said Julian esse discipulam bonam. So everything this convert in the infinitive, and this become accusative. So this become infinitive, and this part become accusative. So discipulam and Julian this is nominative, this also become the accusative. So in we conclude, in indirect statement, verb changing, verb change in infinitive and subject change in accusative. So these two change, and object also, and object also change in accusative. So these change, object is actually always accusative itself, so this part I can remove. So these two major change happen, and we learn in the sentences better that how it is changed. And this sentence, the statement who is speaking, it is past, future is future, present is present, that will remain same. Now we do the sentence so that the concept become more clear. One sentence, the sentence number one. Quisque quisque, this is in infinitive. Inquit in the comma. Semper putat suas ris esse magnas. Suas ris esse magnas. So this means he said, inquit, he said. He said, quisque is everyone. So how this statement become? He said everyone or is, okay, I take everyone. Think, always think. Semper is always, and this means thinks, everyone always thinks, his own things are suas ris, his things are great. His things are great. So this is, you can say, inverted commas. Now in the second sentence, so this essay is the infinitive, and it is used as are. Now the second sentence, postea is post, that mean afterward. Obi vimus servos donorum causa laboravisi. Cosa labora visi. Now, some part more. Ut militis fidelis Harry Naravi Irant Naravi Irant. So see this sentence. First we see this mean afterward. Afterwards, we heard. Now, see this part. This part is in the direct statement. In the direct statement. It is not in that because this is servos donorum causa labora visi and this is perfect. This is perfect infinitive. So we heard that the servant for the cause of gift worked that. Slave. Why slaves? Because it is us that slaves worked for the cause, for the sake or cause of gifts, as would mean. As militis fidels, as this mean soldier, fidels mean faithful. So this as this we take the faithful soldiers as faithful soldier. Harry is yesterday. Naravi Irant means yesterday narrated. It is imperfect. As faithful soldier yesterday narrated. So now we have understood this is afterward we heard this is accusative and this is infinitive. It is infinitive. So like this is we use the if it is direct statement, then we separate it with inverted commas and this servos will be used as nominative and this will be labora, this will be then, not we say this will be labora reerunt. Labora vi erunt. Then it will be this. Right? Now this word changed in infinitive. Now in Okay, now sentence third. Sorry, before third, this is the indirect statement, and how we can write it in the direct. Okay, third we do later. So I write the direct statement. Direct is how. Okay, I make it third. Postia. ODV moves. Now, this is direct statement. Servos is the plural. So here should be nominative. Accusative is changed in the nominative. So it become servi, because servus is the nominative singular and the plural become servi. Donarum posa, this will remain same. Donarum posa. Now this infinitive we change with labora vi erunt. Erunt is the plural. So this is the direct statement. This means afterward or later we can say later we heard. Now servants or slaves for a worked for the sake of gifts, like this, right? Okay, now we take the sentence number 4. This is a rather big sentence, so I think I make for Crinimus Crini Moose Freedom Anti Quam Omnibus Gentibus Anti Quam Omnibus Gentibus Omnibus. So in Latin this is pronounced is gay, gentibus. Iterum Iterum alendam esse. Alendam esse. So this is the sentence. So credimus, credo, credibility, this kind of word. We believe that, because here esse is showing that it is indirect statement. So we believe that fidem antiquam omnibus gentibus, faith of all tribes old tribes, antique mean old, faith means religion, of old, ancient tribes or gentry was because Landam was again not nourished faith of all ancient tribes again again also my God tribes again be nourished or nurtured. That means again the ancient faith will be come in practice. Now, so iterum is again. Now we come to the sentence number 3. Vikini knows story, knows story. Vim ignis magna, vim is force, ignis magna, will to take. Dehink will to take dehink avarti irand avart irund quod word lodam atque dora qpv irunt dora qpv iran so Vikini Nosti, our neighbors, this is our neighbors, have what it mean, what to mean change, what to mean I a turn. So this word like avarjan, this kind of word are built on this avarto, that means change away, turn away. So my neighbor turned away. Turn away. Vim ignis, force of fire. Then vim is force of fire. With great virtue. This is ablative case. With great virtue. Now, quod means because. Because Lordan, they desire, because they desire praise and gift. Praise and gift. Gift. Number 6. Hoc signum periculi. Hoc signum. This is U signum or signal periculi. Totam gentem nostram. Totam gentem nostram tanget. Tanget. Nisi. Okay, I do up to this. Okay. Nisi, unless hostem ex urbe, hostem ex urbe, out from the city. Accipere, this is infinitive. Ac ab Italia pelere poterimus. Pelere poterimus. So this sign of danger, tangent is actually, this is, the verb is tango, that means I touch. In mathematics we see tangent, this, from this verb, tangent is a line which touch a curve. Which touch a curve that come from this. So this sign of danger touch full gentle our tribe, our total tribe or our whole gentry. This sign of danger touch who touch our who our who tribe or gentry, unless this is unless ex urbe excipere we were poterimus, we will be, it is erimus, so we will be, unless we will be able to excipere, take out hostem, able to take out enemy from city and expelled from Italy. And expelled from Italy. Number 7. So this is X means out and ship is Capio. It is from Capio. Catch out. So this is the and Peller is expelled. Now 7. Deus feroci Carthaginis expulso. Deus means leader. Deus feroci Carthaginis expulso spes fidisque spes fidisque virum magnani fidisque virorum magnanimorum virorum magna nimorum rem publicam rem publicam continebunt. So this part, if we see, this is all in ablative. So it is ablative ex. This is ablative absolute. So expulso is expelled, that means forced out. Deus feroci Carthaginis expulso, having been the leader, the ferocious leader of Carthage, has been expelled, or having been expelled, spes and fides, hope and faith of man, great man, contain the country. So this is, we can say, having been expelled the ferocious, or I write here cruel, leader of Carthage. So this is ferocious also, you can see, ferocious leader of Carthage, comma, hopes and faith. Hopes and faith of Magnan, this is great man, of great man will contain, because it is boomed, will contain or hold. The country, the country. Or we can write this: when the ferocious leader of Carthage was expelled, hopes and faith of great men will contain the country. Rem publica. So like this also we can do. Now number 8. Number 8. Cur jucundus horatius, cur jucundus horatius, cur pas humanas, cur pas humanas in saturis, in saturis semper ostende bat, semper ostende bat. So it is simple atque repart, atque, and here atque, this is I, redepart. So why present Horace always show and laugh on the blame of human blame in style? Why? Kurmin why? Semper always. Always. Present Horace showed or used to show and laugh human blames, human fault in style. In style. Number 9. Credimus fidem, this already have done. Aliqui necam. Okay, I do some short sentence. Quisque quisquis, veritatem, recipit, bene educabitur, bene educabitur. Anyone will receive truth or receive truth will be educated well. So here, anyone, quisquis is anyone, will receive truth will be educated because it is passive. Bene is well, better. Number 10. Id factum esse tum non negavit. So this is indirect. Negavit is he deny, or he says that. So negative, this is negative word come from this negavit. He denied, because it is V is there, so it is the perfect. He denied he didn't deny that it can be done at that time. Deny it can be done, or it factum esse, that is, it is in the perfect. So it is having been, or it was perfect passive. So it was done at that time. Tum is at that time, or this mean also we can use then this word we can fix here. Number 11. His rebus pronuntiatis pro nun tuatis igitur. Iam esse hostem saibisti. Ium esse hostim So sayo is, we know, you know, sayo mean, the verb is S-C-I-O, that mean I know, and this is the size also come from here. So, this is everything in the ablative case. So, pronunciatis. Tiatis in Latin. So this is being announced this thing, therefore you know that he is the enemy. This we can say, having been having or when these things were announced, having been announced, these things, therefore, Saivisti, you know, you knew that iam esse hostem. So this is direct, that he is enemy. Number 12. Iam ab hostibus expectari. Ium ab hostibus expectari nunc sentis, nunc sentis. So what is this sentis? This is sentio verb, mean I feel. So this is there, that mean you know, now you know that now, nunc is now, you feel that, feel that he is, because it is passive, he is expected by that, he is expected by hostibus is, actually it is host also sometime, it is enemy also. So, by host, I think better, or sometime we use enemy. Actually, it is something which is from outside, hostibus. So, I think enough for this chapter.